Captain, tupigie risto.
My bro, Jace. Yeah.
Wacha ni washo vile msupa linituma vitungu sokoni.
Yaja.
Nilikuwa naenda kulamba beti juu ya game moja. Nikauliza. Yani naeza lamba beti juu ya game moja. Alafu madho wa vitungu wakadai.
Yameni sukesho kuna betika.
Nikamuliza. Naeza jitua tu.
Mzo wa mkoko wakatokia kadai.
Ni maranga hapi ndak show. Na betika unaeza cash out na withdraw bila charges.
Ala? Eti cash out na no withdrawal charges?
Kabisa.
Ukibetika, unapata mo. Pata mo na betika.
History imeletwa kwako na Betika, the official sponsors of happiness. Gambling can be addictive. Play responsibly. Not for persons under 18 years of age. This advert is authorized and regulated by the Betting Control and Licensing Board. License number BK281. Betika, jukwaa la mabingwa.
Hi everyone, this is Radull live. Thanks for joining us. You'll have to excuse my voice. It's still suffering from Dubai Sevens a week later. Yeah, that's how much I was screaming. Today we're going to talk about football, but before we get there, a word from our partners, Betika. The good news is that if you have a multi-bet and several matches have been played and you're not sure about the last game, probably involves Arsenal, who knows, and you want to cash out, you can actually do that before the multi-bet is complete, and you will get all your winnings up until there. So make sure you take advantage of the cash out option on betika.com. Cash out, bet ikiendelea. Now joining me today is how do I introduce this man? Let me do the basic title, which is Tusker FC head coach Robert Matano. Habari yako?
Mzuri sana.
Also known as the special one.
Yeah,
special one. Why did you give yourself the name The Special One?
Not myself. It's about you and the others.
You were given?
I was given.
But you earned it because, and I'll take everyone back, take us through how you took Sofapaka throughout other leagues, came to the Premier League and won it. I want to relive that experience.
Yeah, it's a long experience, long story.
We have time.
Okay. I was coaching now City Stars. Mm-hmm. And then it was called Wild Hope.
Wild Hope, I remember those days. So it's like 2007, 2008, those sides.
Before that. Mm-hmm. So Sofapaka, we used to play friendly match with them. Mm-hmm. Most of the time. So when they enrolled to play Moy Golden, mm-hmm. we didn't play as a Wild Hope. Mm-hmm. But I released my players to go and help them. That's the time we knew. I knew Kalekwa, and also Kalekwa knew me. So we started friendship. Mm-hmm. And now, when they are in Division One, uh-huh. they stayed in Division One around. Two to three seasons. Eh? Uh-huh. They are about to reach the Premier League, but they didn't manage. So I think Frank Okoth told President, if you want somebody to help you to get this team to Premier League. Look for Robert Matano.
Look for Robert Matano.
So, hey. President came. We met in New Stanley. Mm-hmm. We talked and they agreed to take the job. But I given him two conditions. One, he should leave the team to me. Second, mm-hmm. he should try to be more professional in terms of paying players rather than giving handouts so that we can have a strong team. And we should not depend on him. When he's there, we can play. When he's not there, we are not playing because there's no money. So we should translate what he's giving. It was not enough. But I told him, instead of giving 200 every day, let us give these people
a salary.
For a salary.
Basically, put in the structure so the players are comfortable so you can get the best out of them.
So if it's little money, but mm-hmm. it can help, somebody can sustain somebody because you're going to plan for that money. Mm. Because that's what you have. Mm. He agreed. And that's where we started.
And you won?
Now we won the National League we used to call it
nationwide.
Nationwide. Mm-hmm. We went, I think, unbeaten. Then we built up. we built a very strong team from there, mm-hmm. down there, because I went there. It was late to
2008.
Mm-hmm. So 2008, I was there whole year. At the end of the year, and that year 2008, we played. I went there 2007, mm-hmm, mm-hmm. October. Mm-hmm. So from October, I was recruiting players. When we started the league January, then I started bringing in experienced players and a few young players. Then we managed to have a very strong team. But I told them, this team, we are not building for now. We are building for to go to Premier League. So next year, when we reach there, let's try to do something better. And when we play our first matches, two matches, we beat you, Lindsay, by then. And which team? It was this Tusker.
This was in. This is when you joined the Premier League.
Yeah,
now.
2009.
Yeah.
So we won two matches.
Big teams.
Yeah, big teams. Then I told them we can win this league.
And you've played two matches. And you're already saying we can win this.
Yeah,
league.
Because we're beaten big teams, and those are champions. So what else? That's now we build our confidence. I told the players we can go and win the league. Let's maintain. We need consistent and self-belief.
Let me take you back a bit. You're already playing a Premier League team. You're being told to go to Division One. You didn't see it like, that is, I'm going down. You had that much faith in Eli Kalekwa as president of
Sopapaka. No, all the time I believe in myself. Mm-hmm. Position does not matter to me. Mm-hmm. What I like is the respect. And when you give my freedom to work, I can work anywhere with any team.
You know, you say freedom to work, and we underestimate that in Kenyan football.
About positions, to me, I don't count much.
Those are details.
Those are details. What you do is most important.
2009, you enter the Premier League. Mm. I think that year, I think I watched almost every game at Nyayo Stadium. I was a bit afraid, but at least I'd go to Nyayo Stadium and City and even Hope Center here in Kawangware. Mm. So you win your first two games.
Yes.
In your head, you've already told yourself we're winning the league, despite the fact you had, I think, 28 games left.
Yeah, we can win the league because if we can beat those teams and the way they're playing, we can match them. So only that consistency and self-belief, it will push us somewhere.
And you had who were some of the players who were with you at the time? Because they had come from the lower league. You had kept a lot of the same teams.
At the time, I was with John Baraza.
Baraza, the firing machine.
Yes, James Istuma, mm-hmm. Ajak Nosama. I didn't have big names, but those are a few.
You made them big names.
Yes.
Because if I'm not wrong, that year, Baraza got Golden Boot.
Yes. Uh-huh. Istuma was the best defender that year.
Yeah.
So I brought them from down and also integrating them with the young players. And then announced, we managed to win the league.
In fact, you made them get into Harambee Stars, because I think from there,
Situma
was like the first name on
the
team
sheets. They did look back. They went.
Now you're going through the season. Everyone else is doubting you, including Carol Radull, saying at some point Sofapaka is going to falter. Well, at some point.
One thing in coaching or about myself, I don't give up. That is something God has given me. But the spirit of fighting until last minute. So if you have not lost, you are not. If the game is not ended, you are not. You have not lost.
You have not lost yet.
You're still a winner. So you just keep on working hard and trying to do different things so that you can make yourself available.
Just to put it into context for people who don't watch, who don't focus on Kenyan football, it's like what Leicester did in the English Premier League. But Leicester took, I think, two seasons. They came up, and then the next season they won the Premier League.
Yeah.
You, the same season you came up, you won the KPL.
Yeah, it was good memory to me, and also because the experience I had in football, Kenya football.
And then Akina Radull, he says Radull and friends gave him the title special. Mourinho did. He went to a press conference and said, I am the special one. Your memory is funny.
Because you did something special. You have to be special.
But it was. It was special. Yeah. I think he caught everybody off guard. Mm. We kept waiting for, Sofapaka's going to drop. They're going to drop. Mpaka the last two games, you're like, Apana.
We are not dropping.
They're not dropping, and they've taken
we
the
We draw
league.
Some three, two matches in between. And Madare won two matches.
Mm-hmm.
But we are still ahead of them with 6 points. So that's we managed that gap.
But it showed Matano what professionalism can do. Because you insisting on, one, being allowed to be in charge of the team. We know for a fact that in Kenya, chairmen, officials interfere even with lineups. And then that thing of saying my players must be paid regularly.
Yes, because you cannot work without players as a coach.
Yeah.
First thing, players. Second thing, players. And they have to be motivated. They are human beings, they have their families.
They have to be focused.
When they come for training, they are coming from somewhere. They have a house and they pay. So if that person, his mind is not there, what are you doing with him? You're just punishing that person. So he must be comfortable. At least to get something can push him to perform. Yeah, when I come and try to push my things on them, they know that at the end of the day, they'll get something.
Yeah, that's so important.
Yeah,
that's
so you have to value your players first before yourself.
In fact, that performance was so good that I think the next season, sponsors were almost lining up to sponsor
Samaka. Same year. Same year.
Same year.
Yeah.
But do you say?
Same year, Portland came in. Yes.
Yeah. So eventually, Sofapaka entered the league very loudly. Eventually, you had to part ways with the team. Take us through some of the other teams you managed.
Oh, many. Many.
The highlights.
hey.
Or rather, let me rephrase. What other challenges did you get in other teams? Because when you see a coach has to keep moving, it means you're not getting your demands met. People tend to always blame the coach, not knowing that behind the scenes, the coach has asked for A, B, C, D. It's not happening. And you can't get results.
Yeah. But most of the Kenya teams, they don't give what coach wants. We get very little what you want. If you see different teams from not where we have been, Tunisia, and it's Egypt, you see South Africa, you see different teams all together. But here we get little. But always demands go to the coach and the players. They don't. They forget that coach is just employee. You have to empower him. You have to give him everything.
You have to give him the tools and the resources.
To work. But always they think about the coach most of the time. And also, if you have that responsibility as a coach, also you have to improvise. You have to be yourself. You have to know, I have these players, I have this official, I have this kind of finances. What can I do better? And how can you use what I have to perform?
Let's jump now to Tusker FC, which where you are now.
Yeah.
Where you won the league. Congratulations, champion president. How has that experience been with Tusker?
Tusker experience is not bad, but also is not 100%. You cannot say that you have everything like any other team.
Mm-hmm.
No team has everything, especially in Kenya. We can have what we have. We have advantage. Players can be paid monthly. That's a big one. And the rest is like others.
What's missing?
A lot, a lot, a lot, a lot. But good enough that we are being supported somehow with some few things we get them. But we still need more because we don't have nearly everything.
I want to hear that more. I'm because you're still at Tusker FC. You can't put your employers on the spot.
You know, maybe we are halfway. You are not fully. Because we still need more, but we cannot get more. So what we get, we use, and then it pushes us to somewhere we are.
So you won the league. Yeah. You got to participate in the regional tournaments. Unfortunately, we haven't done so well in the regional tournaments as Tusker FC. What has been the difference between you not getting further?
Yeah, you know, this is also the first time. Eh? And, you know, everything goes with preparation. And sometimes also the quality of the players you have. Like this time, we had players, but we didn't have the variations, how we can juggle the players here and there. Because we signed very few players to that Champions League. And most of the players, our players went like Major. When you have already sent his
when
name.
When you already registered him.
Registered him, he went. So we didn't have enough players to get more options.
Because the calendar was not aligned. In fact, you qualified for CAF Champions League even before the season had ended.
Yes.
And I'm assuming there were deadlines to register the players.
Yeah.
Then the season ends. Then you sell some of your best players.
The players went, so you could not do anything. Ah. What you do is get what you have. But we have tried those players, and we learned a lot when we went to play Djibouti. Mm-hmm. After Djibouti, we came to Egypt. So the quality and also intensity of that games was very high sometimes because our players have not played the Zamalek Champions of Africa. It was something new to them and to us. But now we got some experience a bit and the confidence of the players. So when we played in Tunisia, it was a different Tusker, very different team. Yeah. Very, very different team. You see, that's, we need to be there most of the time so that we can get that experience.
Experience and exposure.
Yeah, exposure.
In fact, I was seeing you on, was it yesterday? On the other day. After last weekend's game, your captain, Eugene Asike, was saying that one goal, I think it was one goal difference that knocked you out of the Confed Cup.
It was not just a goal. It was just a goal because that team scored. But it was not a genuine goal. I can't say so. Proudly, I can say so.
It was not a genuine
goal. It was not a genuine penalty.
You know, you said this before and got into trouble.
It was not a genuine penalty, completely.
Really?
Yeah. So when you talk about fair play, you should play, fair play must be applied. But in Tunisia, it was not.
So you feel Tusker should have advanced in the Confed Cup?
That one, without saying. Because we got a penalty, they didn't give us. First 2 minutes.
We got a penalty they didn't give us.
They didn't give us.
They got a penalty.
Even they didn't
give
that person red card because he was the last one. So they didn't bother. We went on. The penalty they were given was dubious. Because I don't understand law of the game. But law of the game, I think I've been there for long. Face to face, when you are coming. I cannot harm you because we are facing one another. There's no danger there. It's only that man, my defender, got the ball before the striker. And then the striker went to him direct and he fell down.
Penalty.
So those are things, when I say fair play, you can be knocked out the way you are knocked out, but everybody see that we lost. But how the game was, you cannot imagine, you cannot compare us from Kenya, Tusker, and that team which have been that tournament for long. It was a very different thing.
But I hope at least there were lessons learned. Huh?
Yeah, you know, now we're improving also. We need more kind of matches, and our players are going to get used to it. Those people, they can do anything to make sure that they're still in that tournament. And they did it. If you see the body language of that referee,
Don't get my show shut down. But that's interesting to note. That's interesting.
It was serious. It was not easy. And even the crowd itself, they show that they have not won fairly. They are all quite hostile to them against their own team.
Do you think Kenyan clubs are not... I mean, because there's that whole traditional thing that the big clubs, the big countries in Africa or in North Africa, West Africa, and maybe South Africa, and then East Africa, we only seem to be treated like second-class citizens.
Because we don't believe in ourselves, we don't also like ourselves. We do things in casual manner. We don't take football as business, big business. Football is total big business. So you have to spend, you have to put more money to get the quality players, to get the players being prepared, to get everything to the players, to the coach, everything, you get everything, then you can plan. So if you don't have your halfway, or your three-quarter, or your quarter of those people, you're just fighting your own mind.
We are our own worst enemy.
Because you don't like what you do. If you like what you do, you come out of yourself and do everything you want to do.
I know you don't want to talk too much about politics, neither do I, but... would you say we've not been given the leadership to take football to the next level in this country?
You know me, I started with myself. I'm a footballer by nature, from childhood. I played football from how many years young there? Say I grew in football. have that passion. There's somebody who likes football, mm-hmm. but he doesn't have that passion. So me and others, we are different. When you come in, you come in because maybe there's something there.
You're there for the wrong reasons.
Yeah, but me, I'm there because I'm a footballer. I like football. I'm a born footballer. I've been there many years and I'm there. So my mind thinks differently. If I argue the car about football, they'll tell Matano, wewe ni kimbele mbele, kichanguni, nina, nina. But I'm talking what I know, what I see, what we should be, what we used to go through. When I was growing, I saw many things happening. That we used to have very best, good players here. Neva, Tigo, Sianga, goalkeeper, we saw them. And we saw those days, the official used to take those players like babies. They nurture them. They took a player, he feel that I belong to this team. Even fans. You can play without money. We used to play with the very little money. 10 bob, 15 bob, 20 bob allowance. But you don't look for that allowance. You look what you do. You want to achieve something. If you are playing for Gor Mahia, you want to make sure that Gor Mahia is with. If you are playing for FC Leopards, you make sure that FC Leopards with or without money.
So you think our attitude has changed?
Completely changed.
For the wrong.
Yeah,
for the
because I don't think you're a parent. You have children and a wife. And your children can sleep angry. And you have money in your pocket. It's very bad. And that's what's happening in our football.
You're answering me around.
Yeah.
So the leadership needs to be as passionate as Robert Matano.
You know, like the chairman of Gor Mahia Rachel, president.
President.
Who else? Can you count very few?
Who really bring the passion?
And very few. Somebody like I saw one chairman in FC Leopard, Mule. Dan Mule. Another one. I used to the time of Sambu, Les Lokudo, the rest, Peter Nalo, the late. Those are people I say they loved football.
Now we have people who.
The people now, I don't know how to describe them. They're happy, they love football, they love what they get in football.
So then they're just looking for the opportunities in football,
yes,
not necessarily
to use something. Either somebody's coming there to be a politician, or somebody's coming there to get something out of it. Because now they have forgotten that the people are bringing money, they are not those officials, those are players. And the players must be empowered. Football is a short-lived thing. Duration of football, lifespan is very short. You need to give that man, that player money. Because day in, day out is there. He doesn't have any other thing to do. He's just playing football and he's earning. He should earn more. Like any other players worldwide.
So we need to change the leadership of our football.
Football, it has to change. If we want to, first of all, government must come in forcefully.
They've come in.
They have to come in. They should not come two-way, halfway.
Not lukewarm.
No, they should just come in direct and say.
Do you think they've come in a lukewarm manner?
Because I have seen other countries, countries like Angola and other, and like India and the rest and Northern Ireland. Football you cannot manage with federation alone. Football are being managed with the government. Because government, they have everything. They have fields, they have all institutions, they have the dispensaries. The community, the football is involved about the communities. And they should involve more because they have DOs, they have a chief, they have some chief in those areas.
And the county governments, yeah, should come in.
They stay with the people there. The family of those children must be empowered also. They have to be interested to come closer. So they have to work as a family. We should build a football from grassroots coming up. And then money should be given to those people so that we can manage football as professionals. Without professionalism, we'll never end up in it.
This committee we have running the game now.
Yeah.
What's your opinion?
My opinion, they are managers. But they should get technical people to help them. They can manage because they are all around. There's justice there, the ward, doctors, and so forth, different fields. They can manage different situations. But they should get technical people to come and help them to build football. They might have ideas. But we are technical. We are dealing with the situation, real situation about football. So they should also come and ask us, what do you know? What do you want us to do for you?
What's your experience?
What experience? Yeah. Because we have experience, and our experience is about football.
Yeah.
So that's what I said. You cannot be an engineer if you have not gone to engineer. You have no degree. Engineer degree. You have to have that one. You have not been a doctor.
So you wish the committee can consult more widely?
What I can advise them? Mm. They should look for the panel of coaches. Mm-hmm. They should look where the coaches are. And we mobilize our coaches, we meet them, we give them memorandum. The way we want the football being run, because we are facing, we are there, direct. All challenges we are facing, we know how they can be solved. Mm-hmm. We can give them the ideas how they can work with those ones.
Hold that thought. I want us to go into a short break, a very short break. When we come back, we're going to continue talking about what advice Matano would give the committee if they consulted him, and I think they should. I also want to find out why he doesn't want to be national team coach. See you after the break.
Captain, tupigie risto.
Mabron Jace. Yeah.
Wacha ni washo vile msupa linituma vitungu sokoni.
Ya aja.
Nilikuwa naenda kulamba beti juu ya game moja. Nikauliza, yani naweza lamba beti juu ya game moja? Alafu madhu wa vitungu wakadai.
Yamini sukesho kina betika.
Nikamuliza, naweza jitua tu.
Mzo mkuku wakatoki ya kadai.
Ni maranga hapi nda kisho. Na betika unaweza cash out na withdraw bila charges.
Alafu, eti cash out na no withdrawal charges.
Kabisa.
Ukibetika, unapata mo. Pata mo na Betika.
History imeletwa kwako na Betika, the official sponsors of happiness. Gambling can be addictive. Play responsibly. Not for persons under 18 years of age. This advert is authorized and regulated by the Betting Control and Licensing Board. License number BK281. Betika, jukwaa la mabingwa.
Welcome back. This is Radull Live. Thanks for staying with us. Yes, I'm speaking to Robert Matano, Tusker FC head coach, a coach with a lot of experience in Kenyan football matters. But before we get back into our conversation, remember that with Betika, once you've placed your multi-bet and several matches have been played, you have the option to cash out before that cycle is complete. If you look at the last game and you're like, this Arsenal is going to let me down. After seeing the lineup, you have the opportunity to cash out. So take advantage of that feature so that you don't lose a single shilling. In fact, you win all your winnings up until that point. So go to betika.com and take advantage of the cash out option. Now, Robert Matano, a.k.a. the special one. Before the break, of course, you were telling us about coaches and the fact that coaches have so much experience in this country. They can give so much good advice to this committee that has been put in place to run football in the country. What else do you think they can learn from the space, the football space that is there?
Before we go to the committee, Nick, Mwendo, our chairman, president, 2016, I think it's me who proposed him. Mm-hmm. Under odds, people didn't like it. But I thought he has the team, he's young, he loves football, he can help football to grow. But when he came in also, he did what he can do. But one thing I want to advise, in football you cannot do it alone.
Thank you.
You have to work with people, because we have different abilities and capabilities.
I understand completely. In fact, I'm one of those people who I gave Nick so much airtime when he was campaigning because I really wanted to see him in that office.
And you know, one thing, what I've learned in life, arrogance and pride cannot help take you anywhere. You have to listen to everybody.
You don't know everything.
You cannot know everything. Mm. And even me, with my players, sometimes I give them chance to talk so that I can hear them. Mm-hmm. I can hear what they're thinking about me and about the team and about themselves. So you'll get feedback. Mm-hmm. Then from there you can know what you should do.
And nowadays you've toned down. At the time you're very aggressive.
No, I'm the same person. I'm aggressive, I'm the same person. But I go with the moment. If you push me, I'll come out. If you don't push me, it will be the same level. Because
the day you threw a bottle at Nyayo Stadium.
Yeah, that's football is an emotional
one
game.
One of your players had been red carded.
How many times you should be red carded? Every game.
You're so upset at him. Anyway, those are bygones. I guess it's the passion that comes out. So is there anything else you feel that this committee or who you think this committee should consult
a
group of people?
They called managers, CEOs and the chairman of the teams. Mm. Now they should call now coaches. Both nationwide, FL, NSL and Premier League. Mm-hmm. We have senior coaches there. We have experienced coaches. Let us come together. We get that forum for coaches. They should give us 2 days to tell them what we see, what we went through, and how we can improve. It's something you cannot say in 1 day and you get everything. We need 2 days to tell them so that they can compile the suggestions and they go and use that one. Because we are coaching, and we are coaching the modern life. Football is now business. Mm-hmm. And it's a big industry in the whole world. If they use our ideas, the team can be benefited, our players are going to be employed all over, and our league is going to be more competitive.
Absolutely. Let's talk about the national team and why you've avoided that job. I know you've avoided it. Your name has been floated so many times. Harambee Stars
by
coach.
Who?
It's
by
been
who?
There, Matano,
by
and
who?
You always run away.
You know I don't run away. I'm in this country. People knows me. I'm here. And I'm always available. And everybody, even people in the cabinet, they don't appoint themselves. They're being appointed by president.
So you're saying you've never been officially approached to manage Harambee Stars?
Because they see I don't have that capacity. Or I have
no,
on their minds.
They know you won't take nonsense.
You know, in life, you have to be yourself. Yeah. Because if you give him the job, you give him the job to do.
Mm-hmm. Then don't give me the job, then do it for me.
If you don't trust me, don't give me. Mm-hmm. But if you trust me, give me a chance to do what I know better. Mm-hmm. What you need is the results. Results is two way. You give to me, and I give back to you. So you cannot give me the job, then you come behind me. You want to tell me what to do next. You're right, you can come and suggest something because you have seen something, but you cannot insist what you want me to do it. I cannot do it because I'm a professional coach. Mm-hmm. I came there because I protect my image, I have the name to protect. I want to win. Winning is a lot. You do a lot of things to make sure that you win. Secondly, selection must be we have to select through merit. So merit, if you want to win, you have to be yourself. And yourself, you have to get the right players at the right time. The team, people are ready. This national team is not a club team. So you can get the players all over. But also, you can use the same one team to be a national team because they are capable, they are able, they can produce for the country. So merit, it's merit. When I select Radull, and then the other one, they say, hey, Radull and Haiza. That's now selected the national team. And national team always must look national. We have to emulate national outlook. Mm-hmm. So that everybody, at least, can have hope. At a flan, come at the end, at a minute.
So you think it's too, the makeup of the national team is too regional?
I don't say so, because I've been in this country for many years, mm-hmm. and I've seen things happening. One time, I've seen Lopal, but then Abaluya. Only Sianga and Chego Oma, they used to play for our national team, first mm-hmm. team. Mm-hmm. And when it came, Gor Mahia, only Mohamed Abbas and Murila, they used to play for
national team.
The whole team was Gor Mahia. So they are the best team by that time, our best players. So we don't look about who is not there, but who can do what. Mm-hmm. That's what we need, yeah? Even myself as a coach, you give me national team, and my player is not ready, he cannot fit that team. I cannot select him, I cannot. I'll select the player I see. It's not my player, it can be even from Bungoma, maybe from Siaya, Juha, Puko, even Machak, but he can play national team, I'll take him. What we need is merit.
Do you think we do enough development and scouting countrywide before we select the national team?
National team, you know, you cannot select everywhere because it's something short term. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. But we have to develop something long term program. Where we came from, when I was young, we used to have youth Olympics from every province. Mm-hmm. And that youth Olympic, we started from grassroots until we played many matches until national level, a provincial level. Mm-hmm. So you are being selected by merit. So when you have every country has the team, then selection comes so easy. You get the right players, the young ones.
From all over, yeah.
From all over, because those counties have the teams all over. Mm. They have done their tournament until national level, county level. Mm-hmm. So we have the players. You can select them. You choose to go. Today I'm going to which county? Siaya, I'm going to Mombasa, I'm going to where? You get those teams playing. That you are selecting the team. That we have to have those structures from grassroots.
But now it has to be players from the competitive leagues.
Yes, they can be in the competitive league, they can be in the lower league, but they are playing football and you are nurturing them. You know, I have 20 players from Mombasa, Coast Province. Mm-hmm. I have 20 players from Kakamega province. I have county, we say now county. Mm-hmm. So you know you have the bank there, you have the players. Mm-hmm. Every month you move there, you go around for four counties in 1 month. You see the progress. That's what we should do. That's why Bernard's goal did it. Germany, West Germany and Kenya government, they came together. And then the Kenya government requested German to give them the support. So the support they gave them, it was material, about uniforms, water balls, and so forth. And then they came with the Bernard's goal, who was the youth coordinator. And that's why we got Kochiliva, Jaya, Sianga, mm-hmm. and the rest, Mohamed Iheri, Makoha.
They were developed through that program.
We came now from those Youth Olympic, from mm-hmm. those coaches now. Mm-hmm. So those we should go back there. We should go back to the roots. So we know where we failed that way. We overlooked that structures. And those structures are there. But to implement those structures. So we have to empower coaches to do those jobs. We'll get players. Players are there, plenty of them.
Where you are now at Tusker FC, do you have a program where you can go and scout widely?
Yeah, I can go, but you know now I have young coaches there also. Mm-hmm. We have a young team, so we're trying to do the same.
We want send them out, them. They go look for players.
We brought them there, we see them. And then if you get, we have promoted around 4 to 3 players, our own players. Mm-hmm. So that's what we are doing, to nurture the players and then we promote them. So this one should go worldwide, and then countrywide. And that needs government input.
Yeah, yeah.
And that's why we need those people to stay with them, sit with them, we give them the, our ideas. you know, in Brazil, they won 1970. We call it Giant of Brazil. Mm-hmm. After there, Brazil did not win until 1990.
20 years later.
20 years later. Mm-hmm. You know, the Brazil used to play a football called Samba. So they didn't want anybody from Brazil, outside Brazil, even the player from Brazil to play outside in Europe.
Yeah, I remember those days.
So, but Pereira, Robert Pereira Carlos, he went to Italy. And now when he went to Italy, Mario Zagallo was the coach of Brazil, Giant of Brazil. And the captain, Pereira was the captain. So when he came in, they took Pereira's head coach and the Zagallo's assistant coach Pereira, his captain. So when people ask Zagallo, why being assistant to your captain? He says, he's the coach of the team. I'm the assistant coach to him. What we are not looking is about the positions. We are looking about the, what he can do is young. Mm. He can run, he can do everything. But me, I'm old, I can think for him. It's a combination. Mm. So hapa kitu tunalack, niyo. If they see Matano there, on Matano amekuja hapa kuchukua kazi yetu. Hakuna kazi ya mtu, kazi ni ya inchi. What I know, what I have gone through, they don't know. What I did before they started coaching, they don't know. What they are doing today is what I'm doing with them today. So I have more experience than them.
Then what I know as Tusker FC, you can't go to schools, of course, for obvious reasons. But what partnerships do you think that the leagues can generally have with high school games?
One thing.
For scouting talent.
They have to have that sponsorship. We have to have that attachment. We have to have the companies coming in and sponsor the schools and these coaches. Mm. So that we can move around. Because also you want to go and select players. How are you going to reach there? Maybe they are far away from where you are. Mm. Also have some commitment to your team. You cannot have that chance. But if there's good plans from the government, we can move in and supervising these players, those young coaches who are coaching those players, in those areas, so that you can have that data. You have that database. And those players, you monitor them. You see what they are going. Mm. And when you reach after the school being closed, we play tournament, we see how they are progressing. Then you know who you are pick up, or we are pick up, we are pick up. You know the teams, the English Nafania. To come at Togo, to come all to Funga, and at Timoinagan. You know, youth, Ilendogo, in the 17 and World Cup. So if we don't have those grades, yeah, to develop those players, I couldn't have to end up. They would cycle the same players every year, year in, year out. Then to allow performance. We cannot get the same players, play the same team every day. And they are not performing, and we expect them to perform next
by
match.
By miracle. The Kenyans, every game we think we're going to win.
Mtalaum two coaches, kila mara.
It's interesting, you mentioned data, and I know football has advanced so heavily when it comes to technology. I know there are some clubs like, is it Wazito, that have those chips they put on the players and they monitor their performance during training and are we going to get there? Because then otherwise Kenya will always be behind other African countries.
We can be there. If we want to be there, we'll be there. But if you don't want some, if you want to be somewhere, you need to be there.
We're not investing.
Claro. If you don't invest, if you want to do something, we'll do it. Even you today.
Tell your bosses we want that.
If
we
you want to do it, you if you want to do something, you'll do it. Your mind and your heart, if you have that one, you want to do something and you have that drive behind you, you'll do it.
But in our case, or like in your case, you need to take that case to your employers because they probably don't know. Them, they're seeing football's being played, they're happy. You go and tell them, no, football has advanced. We need all this new technology.
Let me tell one thing. One thing, mtu anaweza kimbia peke yako, kafikiri ni mkimbiaji. Ukienda kwa group unapata na baki yumba. Unaona, kumbe kuna wale wanakimbia zaidi yangu. That's the way things are. outside there. You can see everything, the beauty of everything, but behind it, the Giza. So we cannot talk much about it.
So let me leave that for now. In your whole career, which games would you highlight as some of the highlights of your career? Which can you remember maybe a time you won the league, you won a cup tournament?
When I was playing or when I was coaching?
Both.
Hey, highlight.
When you were playing.
Ilikuwa hapa Nyayo Stadium tukishinda Gor Mahia final 1985, 84
January. 84?
Yeah. 5th of February. Leopards FC.
You were playing for Leopards and you beat Gor Mahia in the final.
We beat Gor Mahia in the final, Eastern Central, for keeps. It was memorable.
There are many Gor Mahia fans who watch this show. Right now they're annoyed.
It was a game and a half. We won 2-1. Yeah, we opened Nyayo Stadium by then. After Harambee Stars with the Eastern Central Senior Challenge Cup with Zimbabwe, also they won. And the following, it was December. And January 4th, we played against Gor Mahia. So we won.
The AFC won.
Yeah, for keeps. It was memorable. Yeah, that I can remember.
And as
we used to live in Jacaranda Hotel. We were camping there. But from Nyayo Stadium to Jacaranda, Tulifika saine usiku.
The streets were full.
Hey, that's the same. So.
Yeah, but I miss those days. I miss that passion.
That's the same. Gari ile
the fans and
gari ile kondani inasukumwa. Yani driver ameka. Nini umeka. Gari inasukumwa paka kwa hoteli ndani. That passion. Ungeona hiyo scene, yani ungeona hiyo kitu. You just feel about football. So ukiona vitu zingine unaanza kuambia watu wanaona ni kama you have not be there. Unasikia tu unaachana na because
how can we get those days back here?
When the Kenyans wanapenda ball. Remember some 2 years back. Mm-hmm. 2 to 3 years back. Mm-hmm. Fans wa Gor Mahia walikuwa wanakuja the stadium. They used to follow this team all over. Mm-hmm. Because the team was performing better.
Yeah.
You see, that passion is still there. As far as the team is well organized, don't you appear? Is the team probably in a Tokea Mali? Fans want to have pesa, but they get stadium wengi, but on a part of players who are limp.
Very frustrating.
In a discourage the fans. They end up to have pesa at the next day. When a scare player, I'm a fungi wa nyumba. Now, stadium is major. Imejaaji.
So next time they don't want to pay.
Yeah. So on a
semi. Or even come, maybe.
What's a Tokea Nyumbani? So, even the V2. That accountability. Mtu ametoa pesa yake, players wali, team ina perform. People will come to see football. But there's a player nalia leo. Mtu ametoa pesa yako, ametoka Kisumu all the way, ametoka wapi. Walikuwa nafata Gor Mahia all over. Fans have seen the same. Mm. The so next week, players are crying. Na mulitoa pesa.
Yeah.
Unafikiri nani atende yo stadium.
So the management needs to sort themselves
out. Yes. Lazima angalie. Kwanzia juu hapo.
But it frustrates me because if the management sorts themselves out, there'll be enough money for everyone to eat. If you just organize the way you're running that club.
You see, the team we played in Tunisia the other day, they're business people. They sell nearly everything. They have their shops, they have what all over town. Maluakoko, the sat. Yani team in a business, in a tegemea. Hii ni ya biashara. Ile ingine ni tourism, ile 12 to Sahel. Hiyo pia ni kibia. So unapata teams that generate pesa yao. Because people have faith on them, on their management.
Here you see, when I wanted to buy a Gor Mahia jersey, I was told the person who's selling cannot market on the club's social media handles because they don't get along.
Now
if you don't know Dolphina, who brought me my jerseys downstairs. You know, the network, it's such a shame in how we manage our...
Yeah, that's why Nana Bolete has to grow, because interestingly, me, in a bad way, because for their own.
Finally, Tusker FC next season. This season has been a bit difficult. But is it because of the busy schedule?
Yeah, but it has started. They were not long along. It's only 5 matches. 7 matches. They're still there.
Yeah, but you've
strongly.
You've not won as many as you should win.
No, we are starting the league. Even last time we started the same. 3 years have been tasked, we have not started the league well.
Really?
I have not seen
this,
where.
But this time was a bit difficult because the season ended. I think you had a week. Then you went to Mombasa to camp. Then Confed Cup started.
And then the problem, the biggest problem, it was that we didn't have our all players together. And we didn't rest. After the league, we rest only 2 days.
2 days and you went
two
to Mombasa?
2 days I went to Mombasa.
Others went to Harambee Stars?
Eight of them to Harambee Stars. I have new players. Those new players, they are not registered to CAF. So only we registered 20 players. Those 20 players, 23 wow. players. 23 players, three of them are not there. And the people we are having, they are in national team. So no good preparation.
So they've not rested, Akina Eugene. Hey. He's not rested.
Tumetoka hapo, tumeenda Djibouti, tumekaa 12, karibu 2 days. Atuja work kama team. Kuna wale walitangulia. Alafu sisi tukafuata coach mimi, nimebaki. Players wameenda wengine. So mimi nimepeana tu program kwa hamu. So we didn't know, hatukukua vizuri sana. Tukianza.
Then the league had started.
The league has started. Players wengine hawajakuwa registered. So, kidogo ilitupush sana. But now, the team is charged.
They're starting to stabilize now. So, what's your target for next season?
A target. We are still champions. We have not lost. Nobody has been declared.
So, you can look forward to Tusker winning the league again.
We still are going to work hard to at least to reclaim our title. We are still the champions, and the league has started. Uh-huh. Other teams are ahead of us, but we are coming slowly.
Can you see Kenya going to any World Cup anytime soon?
When you have plans, you cannot just wake up and walk. And you want to go to Mount Kenya, you want to reach there. Never. You have to start planning how you're going to reach there, when and how.
Trust me, I climbed Mount Kenya 2 months of training. Two months uh-huh. of intense training.
Supposed you went direct, unge manage? No. So also to kita kwenda World Cup, we tutaenda. But how?
We must see the process, the planning.
We have to plan, we have to spend.
We don't just wake up.
True to ourselves, we have to be genuine. Kama tunataka kwenda anywhere.
You don't wake up and do roadside declarations. We are going to the World Cup.
Well, World Cup tutaenda, tunaeza, but tutaendaje.
But we need to be serious first, eh?
Kila kitu, Karo, angalia, the way you are, this is a small studio of yours. Mm-hmm. This is that organization and perseverance, sacrifice. You cannot do something without sacrifice. There is no success without sacrifice. Mm-hmm. Never. We Kenyans, we don't want to sacrifice, but you want to succeed. How?
The special one has spoken. Matano. Asante sana.
Yeah.
Asante sana.
Kila kitu yote, you have to come out to yourself. Siato nayo. Giving doesn't mean that you are rich. Uh-huh. You have the heart to give.
True. By the way, that's so true.
Yeah.
So true. That's so true. Well, thank you so much, Matano. Thank you so much for this interview or chat was long overdue. Long overdue. What was supposed to be doing the next one? But yeah. Thanks for coming on Radull Live. I wish you all
late.
The best.
Don't tell anyone
you are late here. So no one knows.
Actually, confess. It actually were free. It's your guilt.
No, I'm the one who can't say it. He's already said it himself. But thank you. I think we've had a good discussion. Yeah. I hope some... do you know me? I'm going to take some of those things you said and send it to that committee and tell them, listen to Matano, please. Listen to Matano. He has something to tell you. But thanks so much. Well, and thank you guys for watching Radull Live as usual every single week. I hope you enjoyed this 1 hour because I did and I think there was a lot to learn. We'll see you again next week. Bye-bye.
Thank you.
Shosho, wamesema hakuna harusi.
Kwa nini? Hapana.
Shosho,
mamesema harusi. Lazima itaendelea. Nani anasababisha harusi?
Coffee.
Pike Brian coach to stream iwe do.
Mfarukwa kwa sauda na kona hapo.
Nasema Safaricom iko na free data kila siku. Sasa tunaweza kustream iwe do.
You may kiss the bribes.
Pata hadi 500 MB free kila siku. Piga star 544# na uchague unlock free data. Mwelekeo ni internet.